Okay, yesterday I was rebuilding this guy and found out that I couldn't get the proper bolts to put it back together with. My Home Depot was out of them, so I had to wait till the next day. But this is what I got. Ever built from Home Depot. Just to review, this is the valve that comes out. There's one on either side. As you see here, this one goes here, this one goes here. The O-rings we used, I used if I can get it in frame. I used this one that's the equivalent to the Danco number 7. All of its dimensions matched. It's this EPDM O-ring. And it is this guy right here. This one, I wasn't able to find an equivalent, so I used the Danco, the number 83 O-ring. You see its dimensions there. And here, to seal the two valves together, or the two valve bodies, is this number 17 by Danco. It fits right in there. I didn't get to go over that on the last video because I got hung up on the actual missing bolts. So, we put this guy back together. Like I said, I took it apart to show y'all again where these O-rings went. This just fits down in here. We have the little silver washer. Fits right up in there. And this spring meets up against that washer. Those washers in there to keep this seat from on this spring from marring the valve body. This little guy goes on the brass on both of these. Put the other side back together. Huh. And then these guys. Fit in here, like so. And under pressure, when you put it together, those meet up. All right, you want to make sure your valves are fully seated. Let's put this everything back together. I had to go get washers for those bolts right quick. I want to make sure that little silver spring in there seats over both brass items. Alright. Now when it's in the car, the screws are actually on the bottom. But when I'm putting it together here, I'm going to be doing it upside down. I last night went ahead and painted this guy. So he looks a little bit better. You can still see he was pitted pretty bad from rust. But we're going to orient him upside down as well. I had to think for a second off camera how this would be oriented so I could hold it up to my face. But this is what we're looking at. It's up against the firewall this way. You've got your two and your two and your singles. Everything has to be oriented the same. And then what you're going to do, I put a washer on there to keep the bracket in good shape. Just get this started a little bit while everything's oriented. And your other side. I'm just going to have to flip it around to keep this washer in place. Just kind of eyeball it, make sure everybody stayed where they're supposed to. And these, fortunately, are 10 millimeter like everything else. Now finger tighten everything first, like you saw me, before I put the tool on. And I kind of clean these threads up by running the one bolt that was in good shape in and out of them to make sure that there was no marred up threads, and it went in fine. So I tested my original over at Home Depot to verify what threads it was and matched it up. But you want to go back and forth between the two sides to make sure that you tighten them up evenly. And again, my washer's getting a little off kilter, so you want to pay attention to that. So let me loosen it up a little and reorient it. It's hard to do this on camera and keeping everything in frame. Okay, got it back in there and seated. Okay, now mine I bought intentionally a little bit shorter because I didn't want the thread sticking up and getting all gooped up and problematic like before. And I used a standard size that I can use a real wrench on to loosen and tighten. So there's the unit, all put back together, all cleaned up. You see all that goop from before is gone. So now it's just time to put it in the car.